edge. You can put it on the board.
Welcome to the Sports Circus. I'm your ringmaster, Sal, live from an undisclosed location and hotel TV. Actually, we're down here in the greater Houston market right now, but I can't tell you which hotel we're at because we're doing special promo for them. Today's show is brought to you by UppercutChops.com. Check out their tasty selection of all-natural USDA Prime Angus, Wagyu, and all their other fine goodies. In fact, wait till you see their best-in-class Wagyu New York steaks, filet mignons, and of course, the best-in-class, which is the ribeye. How about those tomahawks and the big cowboy cuts? Boy, that's good stuff. Check them out. Also, their beef burgers will blow you away. Those Wagyu burgers are out of this world. Give a call, 702-799-9935, to find out what's for dinner. 702-799-9935, 702-799-9935, or check them out for more information at uppercutchops.com. That's www.uppercutchops.com. All right, and a big round of applause for UppercutChops.com and everybody tuning in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast. And, of course, everybody watching on Hotel TV, thanks for watching, as well as everybody else on Cox, Comcast, Spectrum, Frontier, and WOW Cable affiliates, as well as all of our independent radio stations and network affiliates from coast to coast. So we know who's in the Super Bowl at this point, right? It's going to be Cincinnati. Yes! And it's going to be the Rams. How are you going to watch the game, Super Bowl 56? Let's face it, it is officially set. We already know it. And then really, it was set for LA to be in this a long time ago, folks. This is no surprise here. If you watch the season, if you watch the Rams all season, of course, because they're the home team, yet they're actually the visitors in their home field. That's another discussion for another time. Nonetheless, after, of course, the Bengals win, which wasn't really supposed to happen. It was supposed to be the Kansas City Chiefs and the LA Rams. That's what they wanted. What they wanted, Mahomes, the big poster boy for pick your favorite auto insurance and health insurance, whatever the hell insurance company. And of course, they wanted who? They wanted the Rams in there as well. And Cooper Kupp, all world. But he is the best receiver in the game, but he's not the best player. The best player in the game happens to be Debo Samuel, number 19 for the 49ers. Nonetheless, Debo's sitting home watching the game, or maybe he's going to be doing what? I don't know, golfing or something. Who the hell knows? Nonetheless, after the Bengals got themselves a win, and of course the Rams got themselves a win, those two are going to square up for the very first time. And think about this. In the prior two times with the Cincinnati Bengals, each time they had what? Oh, that's right. They had to face the 49ers. So this actually might be a good thing for the Bengals because they don't have to face the 49ers for a change. But nonetheless, the Bengals are in the Super Bowl, as they should be. Very excited to see that. Of course, the game is going to be held over in Los Angeles on Sunday the 13th, not Friday the 13th. So good news, I guess, for everybody over in LA. It's going to be at 6:30 Eastern time. Right now, where we're at, it's Central time, so 5:30 Central. If you're in this part of the country, our big flagship station over in sunny Southern California, KCAA, that's NBC News and CNBC Financial. For everyone over there, it's going to be 3:30 Pacific time. All right. So the early line, of course, we can't forget the betting line now, can't we? So the betting line is at a lofty 3.5 points. And I say lofty for all the right reasons. But it's funny because when you look at the reasons why it's a lofty number, you say, are the Rams really better than Cincinnati? No, they really aren't. They have one player that's better, one player, and that would be Cooper Kupp. Is Matthew Stafford a Super Bowl champion type of quarterback? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. In my opinion, I don't think so. Is Joe Burrow? Joe is pretty damn cool. That's a cool customer. Let me tell you something. You didn't see him jumping around like a mad dog after they won. Joe Burrow is a very cool customer. Does Joe have what it takes to win a Super Bowl? I think he does, but let's face it. All they're going to do, being the Cincinnati Bengals, is they're going to have to find something or somehow to solve Aaron Donald. Is that going to be a double team, a triple team? I don't know what that means, but Aaron Donald's going to be a disaster for Joe Burrow like he is with every other team. I mean, Aaron Donald's one of those guys. But you know, here's the funny thing. Aaron doesn't really speak up much. But for Aaron to speak up last game to say, you know, guys, I want a Super Bowl. I want this, I want that. And Errol, he does not do that. That's just not his character. It's not what he does, generally speaking. So you wonder, is Aaron Donald trying to send a message to his team? It just seems like there's a chemistry problem in LA. And they had the same problem when the Raiders were there. They had the same problem. In fact, well, the Raiders seem to have a chemistry problem everywhere they go. But it seems like the Rams, they went out and got a bunch of great players, right? Add Von Miller to the mix as well. But you know, Von Miller hasn't been heard from much. Jalen Ramsey, not really heard from too much, right? Aaron Donald, steady as she goes. So you ask yourself, are the Rams really even 3.5 points better according to one of those big betting houses, BetMGM, right? I don't know. Well, gee, the line ups have to actually be submitted to the casino about 90 minutes before game time. Gee, why is that? We'll get back to that. But the fact is, Aaron Donald spoke up, and I think Aaron Donald's a little bit nervous about this one, saying, you know, we thought we were going to play Kansas City, who they were going to have their way with on the defensive line, because Kansas City does not do very well against a strong defensive line. And we saw that in last year's Super Bowl, and we saw how Todd Bowles had his defensive giants for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and Tom Brady and the gang. But those defensive players for Tampa Bay absolutely ran all over the offensive line for Kansas City. So here we have a similar situation where the Cincinnati Bengals have a solid defensive line, not a great one, but a good scheme. And they're a very good second half adjustment team. So you ask yourself, if Cincinnati gets out to an early lead, can they maintain with the game plan? I still think they're going to have to make a second half adjustment no matter what. But can the Rams actually be that big home team advantage? I don't think they're one of those clubs. I really don't. Watch out. Cincinnati Bengals could steal this game. Nonetheless, the Bengals, of course, stunned Kansas City with a 27-24 overtime win at Arrowhead. I'll tell you what, as soon as you saw the coin flip, now if we saw that movie the week before, of course, with the Buffalo Bills. And so you wonder, oh God, is Cincinnati going to have the same fate as the Buffalo Bills? It's going to be one of those games. But no, it took an interception, actually, to make the whole thing turn around. So Cincinnati got the ball and, of course, got the game-winning field goal. But then again, this is their third straight postseason win after going more than three decades without one. So Cincinnati might be a team of destiny. You never know. Nonetheless, they came back from that big 18-point hole. They were down 21-3. What a magical way to do this. In fact, that was I think that tied the biggest comeback in championship history. In fact, the Bengals will now play in their third Super Bowl, as I mentioned, and of course, first one since 1988. And if I'm not mistaken, that was the year of the icky shuffle. Nonetheless, the Rams rallied back from a 10-point fourth quarter deficit to beat the 49ers. Really, the 49ers kind of beat themselves along with the referees. And of course, that landed them back in the Super Bowl for the second time in 4 years. And the Rams comeback completed, of course, with a final interception by who? By Aaron Donald. I mean, who else would we expect? And needless to say, that is the largest fourth quarter comeback in NFC championship history, not AFC. But the Rams will get to play in the Super Bowl at their home stadium, like I said, in the second straight year that a home team has done so. Yet it seems the fix was in to make that happen. Now, doesn't it? If you look at all the politics that surrounds this crap and you say, you know, this is very possible. Here's a fun fact. Now, the matchup between the Rams and Bengals will be the lowest seeded matchup in Super Bowl history. Wrap your head around that. I think it's a number four against a number six, or maybe a number four against a number five. I think it's more four to five, which is really good for the league. But is the matchup the right matchup? I don't think the league wanted Cincinnati in there. They wanted Mahomes in there. Did they want LA? Absolutely, they wanted LA. Just like when LA played, well, let's face it, LA got themselves into a game because they got a very convenient no call from the officials against the New Orleans Saints. You may remember the no pass interference, the no targeting call from the NFC Championship game, just in the very, very short past. And what happened with the Rams anyway? They were schooled by Bill Belichick in a very low scoring 13-3 affair. Will this game have a similar fate? I do believe it will be one of those low scoring games. And I think we can all agree to disagree on this. Is Matthew Stafford a Super Bowl caliber quarterback? Absolutely effing not. He is not, period. No, he's a Detroit Lion, folks. You can't do what? Take the stripes off the tiger, or you can't take the mane off the lion. So this guy is not the guy. He's not the guy. And watch this one. Watch and see if Matthew Stafford doesn't get hurt in this game, being the Super Bowl, and then the backup. They go to the backup, and that's how the Rams could possibly win the game. It sure as hell isn't going to be with Matthew Stafford. But remember, there is Mr. Steady, calm and collected Joe Burrow on the other side. Watch and see if Joe doesn't pull a rabbit out of his backside and get himself a win in this Super Bowl. Folks, lots more to come here on the Sports Circus. Don't go anywhere. We're going to probably jump into – we're not going to go into basketball yet. No college hoops yet. We're going to stick with the NFL just because we can. Don't go anywhere. Lots more to come.
Nobody wants to get ripped off, broken into, or robbed, but nobody wants to pay a lot of money to have their home protected either. I've got an offer to tell you about to provide home security for your home for less than a dollar a day. For real, with no installation or equipment charges. And this is from a company rated number one by a leading consumer research company. According to the facts, most of you won't even call unless there's a burglary in your neighborhood or something bad happened. So let's give you a reason. Save money. For less than a dollar a day with no other costs, you can get your home secured. Plus, get a lifetime equipment replacement warranty. You need protection for your home. Call the home security hotline right now.
800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. Again, that's 800-361-3491.
AMP, the multi-format network, is here to help create, produce, distribute, and sell your content. For more information, send a message to info@aamp.tv. That's info@aamp.tv.
Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea, the American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com, or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away.
Come on. You watch the news. Be prepared to pay more taxes. Then if you owe back taxes or haven't filed in a few years, get ready. The IRS, the largest collection agency in the world, will be coming after you. With the power to collect taxes by any means they want to. Hey, they can freeze your bank account, your passport, even padlock your business. Oh, good times. Look, if the IRS claims you owe them $5,000 or more in back taxes and they're coming after you, don't panic. Call my friends at Get a Tax Lawyer first. Their job is to negotiate with the IRS and save you money. They're experts at it. That's all they do. And you can trust them. In some cases, they have reduced a $50,000 tax bill to less than $1,000. If you owe the IRS $5,000 or more in back taxes, call now for a free consultation.
800-908-7016. 800-908-7016. 800-908-7016. That's 800-908-7016. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your ringmaster, Sal, live from Hotel TV headquarters. Can't tell you exactly where, but live from Hotel TV headquarters. Everybody watching on hotel television right now in over 200 markets in upscale hotels and resorts. Thanks for joining us. And, of course, everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, including our friends over in Honolulu on CBS Sports 1500 KHKA. Thanks for joining us on the 49ers, San Francisco Giants, and Alabama Crimson Tide Radio Network. Also over in Los Angeles, our flag station, that's NBC News, CNBC Financial, KCAA. Thanks for joining us there. Also in Las Vegas, KIOF Magic 97.9 FM, right around the corner from the Fremont Street Experience. Big hello to our friends over in Natchez, Mississippi, and Verde, Louisiana. That's 107.1 The River, Mid-South Broadcasting. Also, make sure you check out the streamer. You can stream us live at, of course, The River 107.1. Make sure you also check out their partner station, and that's 104.7 The Gator. Big hello to our friends in South Texas, everybody listening down in the greater Houston market, as well as over in Auburn, Alabama, WAUD, home of the world champion Atlanta Braves. And that's our big friends. A hello to them over in Atlanta, hot Atlanta, 99.1 FM, WDJY, and of course, everybody else listening on Cox, Comcast, Spectrum, Frontier, WOW Cable, everybody watching on those affiliates, and everybody else streaming on social, and also on AMPTV, AAMP.TV. Make sure you like, subscribe, and follow AAMP.TV, and all of the shows that are on there, it's all original content. All right, a big round of applause for everybody there, and also a big welcome in to all of our friends listening in to one of our great partners over in Las Vegas at Curry Leaf. Fine Indian cuisine, flavors of India. Really good stuff, folks. 5025 South Fort Apache Road, number 101, over in Las Vegas, right off the southwest corner of Tropicana and Fort Apache. Never mind eating on the strip, folks. Everybody coming out from Southern California, driving out, and all other people listening in the Vegas Valley, head on over to Curry Leaf Vegas. In fact, Curry Leaf, go to curryleafvegas.com and check out what's for dinner, curryleafvegas.com. But Curry Leaf has incredible Indian food. We're talking butter chicken, tikka masala. We're talking tandoori chicken. Incredible meals, folks. If you've never had fine Indian cuisine, I'm not talking about your regular Indian buffet stuff. This is gourmet food at, believe it or not, buffet level prices. It's really inexpensive. It's so good. It's super good for you too. A big round of applause. 702-527-7977. 702-527-7977. 702-527-7977. That's curryleafvegas.com for the menu. And check out what's for dinner over at Curry Leaf. All right. I'm going to give you an individual round of applause because I don't have the applause button here today, but I'm sure everybody else that listens, you know what we're doing. All right. So back to football. Yes. And you know, the 49ers really dropped the ball. Really dropped the ball. And it really was Jakiski Tart. So Mr. Tart is the one really that, well, he made a mistake on the field. And mistakes happen. Mistakes happen. But I love the fact that this guy owned it. And he stood up and said, yes, I deserve all the criticism. And you know what? He actually does. Because all he had to do was catch a ball that hit him square in the numbers, right in the hands. It was an interception that nobody was around him. All he had to do was catch it. It was a playground toss, and he dropped the ball. Yes, he dropped the ball, which technically cost the 49ers going to the Super Bowl. No question, because that's pretty bad stuff. Nonetheless, but Mr. Tart would like to have that one back. Of course he would. This is CBS Sports. Of course they're going to say that. Nonetheless, the 49ers safety did drop what may have been, according to CBS, the easiest interception of his NFL career during the NFC Championship game. Plenty went wrong for the Niners in the fourth quarter that started with San Francisco up by 10 and ended with them losing by 3. But Tart's drop stood out as the worst miscue and worst opportunity the entire game. In fact, the play came with the Niners were actually up by a field goal with about 10 minutes left in the game. And of course, Matthew Stafford, the overrated Matthew Stafford, he threw a pass into San Francisco territory, and it was a blind one. And guess what? It was right in Tart's hand and dropped the damn ball. It was such an easy play that even Fox announcer Joe Buck initially thought Tart had made the play, but then Tart bobbled the ball, bobbled it again, and the ball fell to the ground. How remarkably embarrassing. Tell me there weren't any nerves over there in the defensive backfield. But rather than go back on defense, the Rams continued to drive and eventually settle for a field goal that kind of tied the game at 17 points apiece. And of course, the game was decided by three on top of it. So look, athletes have reacted to less mortifying mistakes by declining to talk to anyone after the game, but Turk could have easily have done that. And well, guess what? He said, you know what? I'm going to own this one. In fact, mere minutes after the game, he posted a tweet saying that he deserves all the criticism. And he even said, no excuses. I deserve all the criticism my way. Opportunity I dream of actually came up short. I let my brothers down. It still won't define me as a person or player, and I'll only get stronger and better. And then he appeared before reporters and answered questions about the worst play of his career. And Tart said, that's the play I should make in my sleep. An emotional Tart addressed his dropped interception postgame also, quote, as a player, I feel like I let my brothers down. It's a moment a lot of athletes dream of, and you can make the game-winning, changing play. And then, of course, when it came up for him, came up for me, he says, I didn't make it, close quote. So more of his reaction says, quote, obviously my play was crucial. I really wish that I could have it back. But at the end of the day, take your hats off to the Rams. They came in and did what they had to do. I see Stafford's pass, and I'm like, he's beeped up. Can't say that one, folks. It's your rated show. Anyway, we're about to win the game, he says. And it hit my hands, and I thought I had it. I don't know how I dropped it. I didn't drop a ball in practice all week. Caught everything that came my way, and there ain't much you can do about practice like that. The only time you get that moment is when you get it. For me, it's the moment of truth, and the moment of truth showed up, and I didn't step up, close quote. You know what? Good for him for stepping up and saying that stuff. You know, there's a lot of guys that would have shifted in. Well, you know, it could have been any play in the game, and there was still 10 minutes left of the game. Da, 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 da. Well, they could have eaten a lot of clock, and yeah, they still would have had to go down and score a touchdown, but the fact is they were up when that play happened. You can point to that play as being the one play that, yes, absolutely turned it around for the Rams, unfortunately, and the 49ers fell to that one. Oh, by the way, if you're in Cincinnati right now, or if you're planning on being in Cincinnati, oh, geez, I don't know, right around Super Bowl time, the Cincinnati Public Schools gave the students the day off after Super Bowl in celebration of the Bengals. So, look, they actually gave the day off. Yes, so Cincinnati gained thousands of lifelong fans without playing a game. And in fact, Cincinnati Public Schools canceled classes the day after the Super Bowl in celebration of the Bengals' appearance. Yes, the appearance, not the win, because they didn't win yet. So that's just the appearance in the big game. Of course, Cincinnati's sixth graders were doing cartwheels, and they're like, wow, this is real. So following the Bengals' surprising win over the Kansas City Chiefs in the AFC Championship, Stephen Schott, principal at Roger Bacon High School, sent out an email to students announcing that they would not have class on Super Bowl Monday. And from there, of course, others took up the call, and the school board made members like Mike Morosky push for that to essentially be enforced on the district level. And of course, it got approved right away as well. So Cincinnati Public School students usually have the day off after the Super Bowls. Well, guess what? CPS, or Cincinnati Public Schools, used that day as a professional development day, according to WCPO in Cincinnati, unlike WKRP in Cincinnati. Anyway, with the NFL adding another week to its regular season, Cincinnati Public Schools students were slated to get the day after the Pro Bowl, not the Super Bowl, off in 2022. And the new cancellation means students will be off on February 7 and February 14. That's pretty darn cool. Now, only diehard Bengals fans expected the team to make it this far in the first place, and the Bengals entered the postseason as the number 4 seed, which we had said number 5 earlier, actually number 4, in the AFC. And the team, of course, had to beat number 1s and 2s to reach the Super Bowl, and they both did those games on the road, as a matter of fact. Well, actually, they had to beat the Raiders at home, which was really no tough task, that's for damn sure. But they had to beat the Titans and the Chiefs. Titans number 1, Chiefs number 2. Great stuff. Joe Burrow showed very, very calm under pressure. In fact, in both contests, leading the Bengals to game-winning field goals. So good for Joe Burrow. In fact, he'll need to show the same skills against the Rams in Super Bowl 56. And, of course, against who? Aaron Donald. Aaron Donald is a train wreck for the Cincinnati Bengals. So we'll see what happens here. But how about the Cincinnati Public School District giving those kids the day off after the Super Bowl, whether they win, whether they lose? That is a great thing. Tell you what, folks, we're going to be back here with a little bit more of the NFL in just a few moments here on the Sports Circus. Lots more to come. Don't go anywhere.
Attention business owners, you and your customers are listening to this commercial right now. Face it, every business needs customers, even yours. The Sports Circus is a primetime nationally syndicated program that's carried on ABC, NBC, CNBC, and Westwood One News affiliates, plus CBS, Fox, and NBC Sports affiliates across North America, with coverage from Hawaii to New York. Also, the Sports Circus is available to the 180 million subscribers on iHeartRadio, and the Sports Circus gets about 4 million website visitors per month, which could click through your website and bring sales. The Sports Circus provides great content featuring celebrity guests from sports and entertainment to our audience every weekday, which your company could greatly benefit from by increasing your visibility, foot traffic, eyeballs to your website, and calls from potential customers. Call us right now at 702-799-9935. Again, 702-799-9935, or email us at info@thesportscircus.com. That's info@thesportscircus.com. Drive your sales today by advertising with the Sports Circus.
Nobody wants to get ripped off, broken into, or robbed, but nobody wants to pay a lot of money to have their home protected either.
I've got an offer to tell you about to provide home security for your home for less than a dollar a day. For real, with no installation or equipment charges. And this is from a company rated number 1 by a leading consumer research company. According to the facts, most of you won't even call unless there's a burglary in your neighborhood or something bad happened. So let's give you a reason. Save money. For less than a dollar a day with no other costs, you can get your home secured. Plus, get a lifetime equipment replacement warranty. You need protection for your home. Call the Home Security Hotline right now.
800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. Again, that's 800-361-3491.
So, you want to be in show business. Do people tell you that you're really funny, you have a great personality, and you should have your own talk show? Many of us have been told that, but we don't know how to get started. It's easier than you think. Let the pros at Cali Vegas give you a free talent evaluation. Call 949-445-1119 and learn how quickly you can create, produce, and host your very own talk show. Imagine not having to sit in traffic every day, commuting back and forth to the same old boring job. Get started in television or radio today with your free talent evaluation from Cali Vegas. Call 949-445-1119 or visit them online at calivegas.com. Make your dream come true today and create your new career and learn how to become a television or radio star with the help of Cali Vegas. 949-445-1119. Call now. We'll be right back.
back to the Sports Circus. I'm Marie Mastrosel, live from Hotel TV headquarters here at an undisclosed location. But I can't tell you, we're down in Houston right now. All right, folks, this segment brought to you in part by Kelly Vegas, helping people create and host their very own radio, TV, or multimedia talk shows. Kelly Vegas can help people from getting out of city and traffic, hours commuting back and forth to the same old boring job, and host their very own talk show in their very own home studio. For more information, contact Kelly Vegas at 949-445-1119. That's 949-445-1119. Again, 949-445-1119. Or visit online for more information at www.kellyvegas.com. That's CALIVegas.com. All right, a big welcome back to everybody listening in, of course, right here on Hotel Television and on all the other properties, literally from coast to coast, over 200 markets, Nielsen-rated markets in your upscale hotels and resorts. That's exactly where we're at. We cannot tell you which one, but I can tell you that the accommodations are amazing. Also, welcome back to everybody listening in on Magic 97.9 FM over in Las Vegas, sunny Southern California, KCAA. NBC News, CNBC Financial, covering most of the Southland of Southern California from the high desert all the way out to the ocean, to Catalina Island and beyond. And of course, welcome back to everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast. Also Cox, Comcast, Spectrum, Frontier, and Wild Cable affiliates, and all of our independents as well from coast to coast, maybe even the Mars rover too. All right, sticking with football. Why? It's a football kind of show. We're going to do that. Everybody did it yesterday. Let's do it today. All right, so here's something interesting. Now we think of debacles. We think of, oh, that would be the Raiders. Yes, the Raiders, they happen to be an absolute disaster, train wreck, debacle, call them what you will. Nonetheless, according to NBC Sports Boston, the Raiders players are, quote, you ready for this one? Disappointed, close quote, with Josh McDaniels' hire. How remarkably irresponsible and ridiculous is that? Oh, yeah. Hey, man, you can't make this stuff up. Actually, you can. It's just, this is verifiable with NBC Sports Boston. In fact, they said the Raiders are bringing the, quote, Patriot way, close quote, to Las Vegas as they've officially hired Josh McDaniels as their next head coach. And Dave Ziegler as the general manager. That's after a house cleaning, so to say. So therefore, the news wasn't apparently well received among the Raider players. See, now why is that? So according to The Athletic, yes, The Athletic, they were disappointed by the McDaniels hire, figure that one out, as they hoped to see interim coach Rich Bisaccia earn the gig. In fact, more from The Athletic, they said, quote, Raiders players were disappointed to hear the news after they had made a serious push for interim coach Rick Bisaccia and his staff. In fact, the players themselves probably thought the curse was over after they had overcome a series of off-field incidents and won four straight games down the stretch to make the playoffs for the first time in 5 years, close quote. We'll get back to that. Now, The Athletic added that Las Vegas' coaching staff also was, quote, disappointed and a little bitter, close quote. You think? Doesn't really matter. Now, does it? Because the Raiders are not a good ball club. Nonetheless, Bisaccia was interviewed for the Raiders' vacant head coaching position along with Tampa Bay Buccaneers defensive coordinator Todd Bowles. There's a very good candidate right there. So Patriots inside linebacker coach also Jared Mayo and several others over a 12-day search. Ultimately, they opted for the guy with six Super Bowl rings. And it seems to be a little bit obvious that that was the right guy. Anyway, McDaniels originally joined the Patriots as an assistant about 21 years ago, and departed after 8 years to become the head coach of the Broncos. Now, this guy's 45, spent a couple of years in Denver, and won as the Rams offensive coordinator before returning to New England in 2012 to win more rings. Nonetheless, while the Raiders players may feel underwhelmed by the hire, McDaniels is fired up on the opportunity, and even though it's with the Raiders. Quote, I was going to take a special place for me to really leave where I was. And I found that here in Las Vegas, close quote. Okay, so if it was going to take a special place, the funny thing is the Raider fans, they have, well, it's not just the Raider fans. This is Las Vegas. So here's an example. When you think about what's happening in Las Vegas, what has happened in Las Vegas over the years, you would say, you know, what about that Duke UNLV thing from 1991? Folks, let me tell you, the people in Las Vegas still are not over this one just yet. I drive around Las Vegas. I've got a Duke license plate frame. I went to graduate school there. And the people pull up next to me still, you got that Duke license plate frame. What the hell's the matter with you? It's like, get over it. Get over it. UNLV was a great basketball team back in 1990. Nobody cares. You know why? Because academically, they're awful. They stink to join up. In fact, the county, Clark County, where Las Vegas is located, one of the worst, if not the worst, school districts across the entire country. So I don't want to hear any crap, UNLV, anything. Shut up already. Seriously, just shut up. And now the Raider fans, and we do the air quotes and that for everybody on television, the Raider fans come over from Southern California, and what do they want to do? They want to bark. They want to do something. They want to complain. They want to cause trouble. Why? Because this is what Raider fans do, folks. That's all they do. They complain, they complain, they complain. Oh, we should have did this. Oh, I wish you would have that. Oh, it's the black hole. Just remember, inside that stadium, Allegiant Field, which looks like a gigantic Roomba, looks like a giant vacuum cleaner. Oh, they call it with the Death Star. Like, that's supposed to be intimidating. Nobody gives a damn. Two really bad football teams play there. The Raiders and that four-letter UNLV joke of a football team over there play as well. So I got to tell you, folks, it's not a big deal. Seriously. So the Raider players are complaining about something. What the hell are they complaining about? Seriously, you got a guy with six rings that's coming to save the day for you, for Christ's sake. Six rings instead of somebody that doesn't have six rings. Put it that way. That's the easy way to look at this. And so, look, the Raiders have a discipline problem. First and foremost, let's just start right there. The Raiders have a very serious discipline problem. Because why? Think about this. Think about the Henry Ruggs thing. Drinking, driving, doing 150 odd miles an hour, killing somebody, killing a dog too, right? Then you get another one of their wide receivers doing what? Showing a weapon. It's got a loaded weapon on social media or whatever the hell it was. And then went, oh, yes, guess what? The same character gets into trouble. Now he's drinking and driving, doing 110 miles an hour down the 215 freeway in Las Vegas. Look, there's a very big discipline problem over in Las Vegas. Now, is McDaniels going to solve that? Nobody knows. But I'll tell you what, the Raiders are in for a rude awakening, thinking that they're going to get away with everything and anything. It ain't going to happen, folks. It is not going to happen. So for all you Raider fans that are complaining, oh, you got a former Denver Broncos coach, get over yourselves. It has nothing to do with anything other than the ownership trying to win, period. Now, if you can't get on board with that, go find yourself another team or leave the country because nobody gives a damn. So speaking of not giving a damn, a lot of people are not giving a damn about Jim Harbaugh. Now, Jim actually got himself an interview. He's going to be interviewing, I guess, with the Minnesota Vikings. And of course, this is according to CBS Sports. So the Vikings have narrowed their head coaching search to four people. Of course, with 49ers defensive coordinator D'Amico Ryans declining the second interview and dropping out of the running to remain in San Francisco, according to NFL media. But the new name emerged, of course, Jim Harbaugh, the Michigan head coach, expressed interest during a Zoom meeting days after hiring a former 49ers and Browns executive that he is very familiar with as their new general manager. So the Vikings are now set to interview Harbaugh in person for their vacancy. Now, according to the four-letter network, Harbaugh showed legitimate interest during his first interview with the team. As a matter of fact, the Vikings left the interview feeling Harbaugh is ready to make his return to the NFL and be in the mix for the job itself. Now, also in the mix is for the head job, our LA Rams offensive coordinator Kevin O'Connell and defensive coordinator Raheem Morris, along with the Giants defensive coordinator Patrick Graham. Now, cleaning house after the 2021 season, the Vikings could be looking to reunite Adolfo Mensah with Harbaugh. That would be the general manager guy, right? And so those two worked alongside in San Francisco because that was the GM back in those days as well, which I got to tell you, Harbaugh did a great job in San Francisco. Now, the NFL is aware of Harbaugh's interview and is awaiting the formal paperwork that must be filed for all head coaching interviews. And this is Harbaugh's first known interview of the 2022 hiring cycle and the most substantive And that, as a matter of fact, he is really tied to this organization. In fact, it goes right back, of course, back to the 49er situation following the 2014 season. So this guy hasn't been on the rodeo for a while, but guess what? This guy has some legs, folks. And Jim's 58, led Michigan to a 61-24 record since taking the job at his alma mater in 2015. Before that, he spent 4 years with the Niners, won 44-19-1, guiding San Francisco three NFC championships, and as well as a Super Bowl. And he left prior to the 2015 campaign due to differences with the 49ers management, snowflake world, I guess. And at the time, Adolfo Mensa was a director of football research and development for the 49ers. And Harbaugh's older brother, of course, is Ravens head coach John Harbaugh, which has been targeted for several teams and their head coaching jobs. But guess what? This one is Jim's to win. Back here, we're going to talk about this.
You don't sit behind a desk every day to earn a living. You're out and about making it happen. And sometimes you get a little bit behind on your paperwork, you know, like bookkeeping and paying your taxes. It's easy to get behind on paying your taxes. It happens to the best of us. And you know what happens next. The big bad IRS comes knocking on your door. And when that happens, you need to call the good old boys at the Tax Doctor. Let them do what they do best, deal and negotiate with the IRS so you pay the lowest you can in back taxes that the law allows. We are a 100% U.S.-based company, and we've saved our clients millions over the years in back taxes. If you owe $10,000 or more in back taxes, call my friends right now at the Tax Doctor and learn more.
800-989-1694. 800-989-1694. 800-989-1694. That's 800-989-1694.
Nobody wants to get ripped off, broken into, or robbed, but nobody wants to pay a lot of money to have their home protected either. I've got an offer to tell you about to provide home security for your home for less than a dollar a day. For real, with no installation or equipment charges. And this is from a company rated number one by a leading consumer research company. According to the facts, most of you won't even call unless there's a burglary in your neighborhood or something bad happened. So let's give you a reason. Save money. For less than a dollar a day with no other costs, you can get your home secured. Plus, get a lifetime equipment replacement warranty. You need protection for your home. Call the Home Security Hotline right now.
800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. Again, that's 800-361-3491.
Tahi Boti Club's original Pure Pound Iarco Super Tea helps build red corpuscles in the blood, which carry oxygen to our organs and cells. Our organs and cells need oxygen to regenerate themselves. The immune system needs oxygen to develop, and cancer dies in oxygen. So the tea is great for healthy people because it helps build the immune system. And it can truly be miraculous for someone fighting a potentially life-threatening disease due to an infection, diabetes, or cancer. The tea is also organic and naturally caffeine-free. A one-pound package of tea is $49.95, which includes shipping. To order, please visit bestsupertea.com. The first word is best, spelled B-E-S-T, then the word super, then the word tea. The complete website is bestsupertea.com or call us at 818-274-8270, Monday through Saturday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. California time. That's 818-274-8270, bestsupertea.com. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your ringmaster, Sal, live from Hotel TV headquarters. Yes, Hotel TV headquarters, folks. Make sure you check out thesportscircus.com for upcoming guests. Our prior guest, boy, we got some great ones coming up there, folks. How about John Stockton? Yes, Hall of Famer John Stockton is going to be with us. Bobby Kennedy is going to come back as well. You can call him RFK Jr. You're going to have Kevin Sorbo back here, probably with Mr. Kennedy. And lots more big, big names coming up here. But guess what, folks? Lots of other shows that we have gone through. We've had some great guests. Make sure you match up the guests on the homepage of thesportscircus.com with the recorded shows page, which you can find on Apple Podcasts, iHeartRadio, Spotify, or click on the logos for the affiliates for NBC, CNBC, and also for CBS Sports, etc. Just click on those logos. It'll bring you to a page with, I don't know, 1,300 odd shows, whatever the hell it is, some crazy amount. Anyway, get a gigantic bucket of popcorn and go ahead and listen to, I don't know, 10, 12, 50, or 100 of those shows at a time. All right, folks. And make sure you also check out the partners page. The partners page has some of our greatest partners, and all the way from the very beginning when we started this show. And we're going to go ahead and ask you to check that out. And in fact, one of those is the College of Southern Nevada Athletics, CSN Coyotes. .com for upcoming games and events. Check out those baseball games. Boy, they're great. Women's softball games are fantastic. Basketball, soccer. Yep, they got them all, folks. Volleyball. Tell you what, CSNCoyotes.com for upcoming events and games. That's CSNCoyotes.com for the College of Southern Nevada Athletics. All right, welcome back to everybody. That's an easy way to say it. Everybody, make sure if you're watching on AMPTV, WAMP.TV, make sure you like, subscribe, and follow. Also follow us on all social media as well, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. You can't get away from us, folks. We're everywhere. All right, over to college basketball. Now, the top 25. Well, let's check, take a look at that. Now, according to the Associated Press, because right, we have the AP poll, Auburn keeps winning. Of course, everybody knows that. Well, I think they've won 20 in a row now. In fact, Kentucky is rising, and the SEC is putting its imprint atop this week's poll, and the AP Men's College Basketball poll is looking pretty darn good. Now, Bruce Pearl's Auburn Tigers earned 49 of the 61 first-place votes. Those guys are legit, folks. Of course, right over in Auburn, Alabama, WAUD, thanks for joining us over there as well. So Auburn Tigers, these guys are rolling right now. First-place votes, 49 out of 61, not bad. And, of course, the new poll and extended programs first stay at number one for a second straight week, while John Calipari's Wildcats jumped number five. Yes, they jumped to number five for the program's highest ranking in the top 25 and more than the last couple of years. In fact, the SEC now has a pair of top five teams for the first time in about 3 years. So Auburn's 20-1. Well, actually, they've won 17 in a row. Thought it was 19, 20 games. Who the hell knows? Doesn't matter at this point. They're ranked number one. As a matter of fact, they've won 17 in a row since losing a double overtime game to UConn. Now, that UConn team is legit. That's Bobby Hurley's brother, if I'm not mistaken, that is running that team. So watch out for those UConn Huskies. In fact, the Tigers eked out a very tough win at Missouri against those Tigers in their first game at number one, and then followed a nice win over Porter Moser and the Oklahoma Sooners. You may remember Porter Moser was the coach at Loyola University of Chicago, brought them to the Final Four. And of course, that win over Oklahoma, not to mention the school reaching a deal with Mr. Pearl for an 8-year contract extension. That's pretty good stuff. And so, of course, he said it's been a good week, you think? Now, Kentucky, 17-4, had the week's biggest jump, going up seven spots after winning by 18 in Lawrence, Kansas. Folks, wrap your head around that one. Kansas lost by 18 at home. That's a really big deal. And in fact, that's the highest ranking for a Kentucky team for the last, well, shoot, we'll call it the last 3 years now. Is it, well, 2019, 20, yeah, whatever. Let's say the last couple of years, when the Wildcats, of course, spent 1 week at number one in the first regular season poll and sat at number six in early in March. So they really haven't done too much in the last several years, seemingly. Now, quote, every time we play like a team, I don't think anyone could stop us, close quote. Well, that's kind of a loaded statement. Anytime we play like a team, isn't that with every team? Come on, man, you can do better than that. And that's, of course, one for one of the big men. with the Kentucky Wildcats. So whatever, man. They really need to have some media training. They really need media training. You got to teach these kids how to speak to the media. A lot of them, they have no damn clue. And by the way, a lot of these kids are one and done on top of it. So if you think they're in trouble now with speaking to the media, wait a year or so. It's going to get even worse. But of course, this marks the first time the SEC had two top five teams since Feb of 2019 when Kentucky was fourth and Tennessee, yes, the Tennessee Volunteers, was number five. In fact, so the top tier were like that Gonzaga remains number two and earned the other 12 first place votes. But who do they really play? Look, they lost to Duke. That's the team they lost to that really matters. And it was a great game, by the way. That was a phenomenal game between Duke and Gonzaga. Now, UCLA climbed to number three. And, of course, those Boilermakers from Purdue, which claimed its first number one ranking earlier this season, is number four. And the Bruins opened the year up at number two and have now spent 11 weeks inside the top five, while Purdue has spent nine of those weeks in the top five. That's pretty good stuff. So, look, think about this. There are some teams that stumble and bumble and rumble and jumble and dumble. But Houston and Arizona were next after Kentucky, followed by reigning national champion, the Baylor Sic'em Bears, now, which had stumbled after a 15-0 start and a 21-game winning streak that began, well, geez, with last year's title run. Now, Baylor spent 5 weeks at number one, but has split its last six games. How awful is that? After their loss to Alabama. In fact, Baylor and the Bears, four spot slide. Yes, marked the first time in the Big 12 hasn't had at least one team in the top five since the final poll from 3 years ago. So that's a big slide. I mean, a team dropping four slots after that great start, that's a big deal. But Baylor remains the only team in the country to rank in the top 10 of KenPom's adjusted offensive efficiency, which is 118 points per 100 possessions, and adjusted defensive efficiency at 89.1. It's pretty good stuff. So who's rising? Who's rising out there? How about Kentucky at the biggest jump? Number 18, Illinois, also had a notable move, jumping up six spots following last week's win against Michigan State. In all, nine teams rose in the polls recently. So who's sliding? Of course, Kansas, right? Kansas with that 18-point loss at home. They fell five spots to number 10 after its loss to Kentucky. But it was number 25, LSU, that took the week's biggest tumble. In fact, they fell completely out. The Tigers fell six spots after losing to TCU. Oh, yeah. Number 19, USC. Yes, 19. Remember, they were in the top five recently, but they hadn't beaten anybody. USC, number 19, and number 22, Tennessee, joined Arizona, Baylor, in falling four spots. In all, nine teams fell from last week's rankings. So we're starting to see the cream rise on top, and those that were not really contenders, but maybe pretenders, those are the ones that are kind of dropping down. Now, status quo, let's think about this. Six teams remain locked in for a second straight week, including number 9, Duke, number 11, Wisconsin, number 16, Ohio State, number 21, Xavier. Four solid teams. In fact, recently it was Purdue and Ohio State locked up in a really good game, and Purdue ends up winning that game by three. But a very, very difficult game. You know, Purdue's got that big 7-4, 7-5 Edie, but they have that inside-outside game from their big man. Then they also have, this is a loaded team. This is one of those years, folks, that I think any one of 10, 12 teams could actually win the national title this year. It's really wide open. You can't say, well, this one's a clear number one. I mean, Auburn is a very good number one, but Purdue is just as good as they are. And when you're looking at across-the-board talent, you say, you know, Gonzaga, day in and day out, week in and week out, year in and year out, those guys are always there. They have great recruiting, and they've got giant players that can play an inside-outside game. So Gonzaga's always there for some reason. It's just that way, folks. So is Baylor going to stick around? Who the hell knows? But the fact is, anything can happen this year. It's one of those years. So, you know, you think of welcoming back to the top 25. How about Texas? Yes, UT Austin. Well, guess what? They rejoined the polls back at number 23 as the lone addition following a one-week absence in a season that saw the Longhorns open up, yes, at number 5. So that's another one of those overblown, overstated rankings. Now, of course, farewell. We're going to bid farewell to Davidson. They fell out of the polls from 25 after earning the program's first AP Top 25 ranking in 7 years. But how about this? Which conferences should we really be watching here? How about the Big 12, the Big East, and the Big 10? So remember all those bigs, right? So you got three of those, and they're all tied for the national lead with 5 ranked teams each in the latest poll. Now, the Southeast Conference has 4, followed by the Pac-12's 3, the ACC West Coast Conference, and American Athletic Conferences. Each had only 1 team. Think about this, folks. The ACC with 1 ranked team? And we're talking the teams of Duke. Of course, Duke is the ranked team. How about Carolina? We're the Chapel Hillbillies. So we have no Carolina. We have no Wake Forest. We have no Florida State. We have no Miami. I got to tell you, Florida State and Miami, a couple of really good clubs. And you kind of scratch your head and say, why aren't one of those, if not both of those teams, ranked? You'd never know what you're getting with those teams. You really don't, right? So you've got nobody showing up. How about Virginia? How about Virginia is just a couple of years removed from a national title. How about Virginia not even being ranked? What the hell is that all about? So you think of the ACC, you should have 3, 4, 5 teams ranked in the top 25 every year, year in, year out. We're going to go with Duke, Carolina, Vitek even, University of Virginia, and one of the Florida teams. That's 5 teams that should be ranked. But guess what? They're nowhere to be found. It's only Duke. And that's when you know the mighty have fallen. Even those boys that play over in South Bend, Indiana, and that would be Notre Dame, because Notre Dame is in the ACC when it comes to basketball. So why is it that the ACC has fallen? And remember, this is Coach K's last year as the coach for Duke University. John Shire takes over for him. So Coach K is helping with the recruiting. But, buddy, this is a very different ACC. And that music says it's time to go, because we don't even have an answer for why the ACC is stinking up the joints. They did the same damn thing in college football, too. So it's the changing of the guard when it comes to the conferences. And the ACC is really starting to falter, folks. We don't know what's going on. But we know Duke is always going to be there, as they always are. That's going to do it for the Sports Circus today. I'm your ringmaster, Sal. And we'll see you next time right here on your favorite station. Until then, so long, everyone.
Small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you start up with capital, business strategy, sales, and marketing, and establish your company with a physical location or an online presence on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea. Then American Business Trust can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com. Or call them at 657-600-1876. That's American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They'll help your business right away. That's American Business Trust Company. Online at abtrustco.com. American Business Trust Company.